two rifles right there. Grab them.
Come on, Wilhelmina, let's go for a walk. Come on, let's go. Jonathan's been wounded. We need to get him up here. Oh, Jonathan, you went and got yourself shot up. Oh, no.
Thine eyes have seen the glory of the coming of the Lord. He is trampling out the vineyards where the grapes of wrath are stored. He has missed the faithful lightning of his terrible swift sword. His truth is marching on.
There you go, dear.
We're running low on bandages.
Cut up the clothing, whatever we can find. So kind of you to mend his jacket.
It's very important to them to have a clean uniform.
Of course it is, dear.
Dear, the war is over. I just got the news. Oh.
Where's Chamberlain and the men?
Well, it's nice to see your fever's break.
I gotta get back in the fight.
Oh, you won't be doing that. The war's over.
What do you mean it's over?
Lee surrendered. It's time to go home.
Go home?
It's a miracle we found you in time. Oh, Wilhelmina found you right away. Oh, she's a good dog. Oh, Wilhelmina. It's time for us to leave Virginia. Your wound is healing very nicely. You must have a special purpose indeed.
I doubt that. Guess so. You're heading back up to Maryland.
There is a group heading to Maryland tonight.
I'll pass. I travel alone.
So where are the rest of the wounded? Where are the doctors?
All the doctors and soldiers have gone. We stay behind to take care of you. We're sending you off with some clean bandages, and Molly has repaired your uniform for the trip home.
Thank you, Molly.
So why is a young girl in a field hospital?
Molly's such a sweet girl. Her family died with smallpox, and she was the only one that survived. So I'm going to take her back to England with me. Sweet, lovely child.
That's mighty nice of you to take care of her. Look, I must be going while there's still daylight. It's a long march back to Maryland.
Food for your stomach and food for your soul.
Oh, look at her. She really likes you, Jonathan. Why don't you take her with you? I can't take her with me.
I can't take a dog with me. Can't you and Molly take her?
I can't take her with me back home. She might prove useful to you. After all, she did find you. She did get me to you to save you. So really, you kinda owe her.
Well, if you can't take her, I guess I'll take her. But only until I can find her a good home. But you're going on the lead, Wilhelmina. Confederates are gonna be passing me by, and I don't want you getting me into trouble.
She'd be a good dog, Jonathan.
All right, Wilhelmina. It's time to go.
I'll be with you, Jonathan. Safe travels home.
Oh, safe trip back to England. Come on, we're gonna keep moving. I don't trust you yet, okay? I'm
gonna have to keep you tied up. I don't want you running off, getting me into trouble. Found us a green pasture. Huh? Okay, this is the place to rest. I'm gonna set up camp here. That's not your bed. That's not your bed. That's where I lay my head, Wilhelmina. Come on, lay on the grass. Come on. You're not gonna move, are you? Okay. I'll give you this one. I'm tired. Okay, you can have my bed. I know you're hungry. You don't have to eat grass, okay? Here's some bread. There's not a whole lot here for both of us. Let me see your teeth. Now you're just a pup. You won't be growing on that. You can't just eat bread. I hope you're a good hunter, Wilhelmina. gave me my bed back.
Thanks, Wilhelmina. Hey, wait. Come on now. Okay. I have some writing I need to do. Let me write. Come on. Here. I'm too hot. There you go. Where'd it cut me? No, don't eat it. Come on. Wear it. There you go.
Dear Father, I'm writing you to tell you that I am safe and I'm coming home. It's been a long time since we last spoke, and I regret that I did not leave you on good terms. I would like to repair our relationship. I want to tell you that I love you, and I will see you soon.
Come on, Wilhelmina. Come on. There she is.
Good dog. You came back to me. Yeah.
Nice breeze coming in, Wilhelmina. I know you're gonna like that with all that fur you have on. It's nothing worse than this wool jacket.
I know, Wilhelmina, you're right. I just need some rest.
What are you doing, Wilhelmina? Huh? Is that you making all that noise out here? Don't take my stuff anymore, Wilhelmina. Get down from there, boy. Come on.
I'm not gonna hurt you. No, Wilhelmina, Wilhelmina. Calm down, girl. Calm down. She won't bite you, boy. She was a field hospital dog. A rescue dog, not a war dog. There's nothing to be afraid of. Follow me.
What regiment were you, boy? Maybe I can help you find your way home. I'll give you time to speak. I know you're probably a little nervous. If you want to keep going back to this boy, then you can take her. Just put Wilhelmina right there. Have a drink. Eat this. I'm not your enemy anymore. You'll come with me until we reach the next town. Then maybe you can find who you're looking for. You have a better chance with me than being lost out here in the woods. I'll be doing some hunting when we get to a new location. I can find us more to eat. Come help me with the tent. You two keep up. We have a long ways to go. Come on. Here, you can sleep with that. Good dog, you brought us supper. Come on, it's your turn, girl. You stay here. I'll be back.
What are you doing out here, boy? Why'd you leave the campsite? If you're scared of your own shadow, you should have stayed in the camp. You need courage to be a soldier. Let's go. Time to get up, boy. If you have the courage this morning, help me pack up. We gotta move. I'm sorry about questioning your courage. I want to let you know you earned your right to be called a soldier today. And Wilhelmina, you earned the right to get off the lead. Come on, let's get a move on before he wakes up. So goes the battle cry of freedom. This is the sound of righteousness and truth. This is what it's like to stand up for God and the red, white, and blue. I hear the cannon shout my name. Maybe this is where I die. With a letter from home and a gun by my side. Then I feel a gentle tug as I'm getting pulled from the mud. God has sent a saint to deliver me from this pain. All right, Wilhelmina, I know I told you you're gonna be off the lead, but we're getting closer to town. And I have to put you on just for a short while, okay? Why don't you trust me yet? Didn't I just prove to be trustworthy? You're still not going to speak to me. You know, it takes courage to trust someone also. And it doesn't matter the color of our uniforms. It doesn't matter the side we fight on. There's good men on both sides. You're going to speak to me soon. Well, I'm not going to give you any more water.
I find myself becoming attached to these two, as they bring me many needed smiles. Wilhelmina has sparked a fire in my heart that I didn't even know was there. The feelings of love, compassion, purpose, wanting to take care of something or someone. I look forward to many more days with Wilhelmina and this poor lost boy.
You two stay close to the camp. There's no telling who's in the woods. I gotta do some hunting to get some more food.
Put that down before you hurt yourself.
Try me.
Who are you, woman?
Catherine.
What are you doing with those bodies?
I'm trying to survive.
It makes sense that you'd have no respect for soldiers.
You don't tell me what I have respect for and what I don't.
You're a feisty one, aren't you?
I've had to be because of men like you.
What kind of man do you think I am?
Judgmental, for one.
Perhaps. Where are you from?
Nowhere.
And where are you headed?
New York. You think I want to pick through dead bodies for a bit of food?
I can at least find you something better to eat.
I get by my prayers, and that's all I need.
I have a boy I'm taking to the next town. I can see you safely there.
I'll do fine on my own.
I
thought I told you to stay at the camp.
Looks like he will be needing me after all. That's no boy.
What do you mean? I'm confused. I'm losing my mind.
I've got just the thing for her.
No wonder you didn't talk.
This'll do just fine. And it's your size.
Why didn't you tell me that was a girl?
What's your name?
Abigail?
You could have told me. Don't walk away from me. Explain yourself. What do you mean?
My older brother went off to fight in the war, and a few months ago, my parents received word that he had been killed. I was very close to him, so to get my revenge, I decided that I would join the fight.
How many soldiers did you kill?
None. Not yet.
Not ever, because we're taking you back to your parents.
No! I won't go back. I can't go back until the war has ended.
The war has ended. It's over, and I'm on my way home.
I'm sure your parents are very worried about you. And having lost your brother recently, I bet they need you more than ever.
I didn't think about it that way.
As soon as we get to town, we can find you a carriage to take you home.
If you don't mind, I'd like it better if you took me by foot.
Where do you live?
I'm just at the top of Virginia. You'll be passing through it on your way to Maryland.
Is that right? All right. I'll make sure to hand deliver you by foot.
That's all settled. How's about we have some singing and dancing?
How's about we not?
We're tenting tonight on the old campground. Give us a song to cheer our weary hearts, a song of home and friends we love so dear. 'Cause many are the hearts weary tonight, wishing for the war to cease. And many are the hearts looking for the right to see the dawn of peace.
What are you doing in here?
I came to check on you. I heard you scream out.
I'm sorry, the war hasn't been very easy on me.
The war hasn't been easy on any of us.
I didn't mean you any harm.
No, I'm fine.
I'm sorry.
Sometimes I cry out in my sleep. It always helped to have someone there to wake me.
Well, that was thoughtful of you. You were married?
No, I've never been married. But I've given my life to Jesus. I may not have been a saint before, but I'm sure trying now.
I didn't mean anything by it.
Do you believe in Jesus?
I wouldn't say I don't believe in Jesus.
What kind of an answer is that? He is the great comforter. Maybe it might help you to have him if you don't. He can change a person through and through. Doesn't matter what you've done.
Thou shalt not murder. I've done my fair share in this war.
There was plenty of men fighting wars in the Bible, and God made kings out of them. I'm sure you didn't want to do what you had to do, but it had to be done. All men are created equal, and all men have rights to the same freedoms. We all bleed the same color, and we're all children of God. Whatever pain you have inside that head ought to be given up to God. And don't you have another thought about it. You've been fighting this whole war for others' freedoms, and yet you've never really had it for yourself. The one freedom you really need can only be found in Jesus.
Let's go.
Abigail, where's Catherine?
She went out to collect some eggs for breakfast. She's been gone a while, actually.
Come on, Wilhelmina. Let's go look for her.
She's a pretty lady out here all alone.
I don't know who you're talking about. Do you know Jesus? I think it's about time you find him.
Wait here.
So where's your husband?
I have no husband. I'm alone.
How did you manage not to break them?
It's not the first time I've dealt with the likes of them.
Might I have a word with you?
Yes.
Why would you tell them you were alone?
Don't you know what they could have done?
Of course I know the risk of being vulnerable. I wouldn't dare put your Abigail in danger.
No, you just put yourself at risk.
I didn't expect you could take on two men so easily.
I didn't expect I'd be jealous.
Jealous?
I'd be rather upset if something happened to you in my care.
You would?
Even though the fighting has stopped, there's still a lot of tension in these woods and men passing through. I'd like it if you stay near the campsite.
I will do that. Jonathan, your arm! It's bleeding!
It's okay. I just opened up my gunshot wound.
Gunshot?
I told you it's nothing.
In the tent. Abigail, boil me some water.
All right. There's fresh bandages in my pack.
Ah, it's hot.
It's supposed to be.
Have you dressed wounds before?
Uh-huh.
You don't share many details about yourself, do you?
There's no sense in going back in the past. It only matters who a person is now, and who they choose to be for the rest of their life.
I'd like it if you tell me more about yourself.
I was born in a saloon. My mother worked and died there. She was trying to settle a gambling dispute and was shot. The other ladies took me in and raised me. And I became a dance hall girl at the age of 7. I sang and danced to entertain the men. And at first, it was fun. But as I grew older, the men grew rowdier and rowdier. I learned to defend myself quickly. One day, a preacher came around, talking about somebody who could save us from our sins. Naturally, they kicked the poor fellow out, but I ran after him, begging for more of his preaching. And when he was done, I knew I needed the Jesus he spoke of. And right then and there, in front of that saloon, I gave my life to him. I took what little I owned, went and bought a real respectable dress. I left a new person.
That's a mighty fine story. My father was a preacher. I accepted Jesus when I was a child. He did his best and I did my worst. As I got older, I wasn't the easiest to handle. But he did his best. And we didn't leave on good terms. So, I'm heading back so I can make things right. You did a good job. Thank you for patching me up. They say people don't change, but I see we both have. Come unto me, all ye that labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn of me, for I am meek and lowly in heart, and ye shall find rest unto your souls. For my yoke is easy and my burden is light.
We could use a moment of privacy if you don't mind.
Okay, we'll wait here.
We'll be back.
Taken Wilhelmina.
Who's taking her?
Those deserters. Same guys from last time.
Are you you okay?
I'm okay. But say a prayer for us. We're gonna need it. Come on, let's go. This way. We're gonna rush them. When they see three of us and I get into the camp, you two run for safety, okay?
Yes.
I'm gonna take care of it.
We can do that.
Are you ready?
I'm worried they will be really angry with me.
I imagine they'll be overjoyed to see you, just like the prodigal son's father.
You've been reading your Bible.
I have.
No matter what you've done, you can always go home again and remember for the rest of your life that God's love we'll be waiting for you to come home, too. I'll remember. Thank you for bringing me here.
It was my pleasure.
I'm really, really lucky to have met you. Thanks for everything.
I guess that just leaves you. I don't think I can walk you all the way to New York.
I don't suppose you could.
I can take you to the next town and get you a ticket. Confederates didn't take the B&O out there.
All right.
You keep an eye on Catherine while I'm gone, girl.
gonna go get you a ticket. I'll be back.
Good to see you back, Mr. Clark.
Thank you. I need a ticket to New York one way.
That'll be 9 cents, please. You've a letter in your postbox. Shall I fetch it for you?
Yes, that'll be fine.
I'm terribly sorry to hear about your father.
What do you mean?
I'm sorry. I thought you knew. Your father passed away.
No one notified me.
He was a good man. I'm sorry for your loss.
Thank you.
He was so proud of you, Jonathan, going off to the war and all.
I always wanted to make him proud.
It's a good thing you're back. Your land was about to be filed as unclaimed.
I was trying to make it back in time. This war has taken everything from everyone. I don't need to read this. I must be going.
Do you boys know the story in the Bible about the money changers? Allow me to show you.
No one's gonna hit a lady today. Are you okay? Sit down. I can't leave you alone for a second, can I? Where were you, Wilhelmina?
Well, gambling is a sin, and I felt they ought to know that.
You need to be more like Wilhelmina. Quiet. A good girl.
I'll talk to anyone I please about Jesus.
Look, I don't have time for this. You're gonna end up like your mother, always getting into trouble.
You have some nerve talking to me like that.
I got more important things to do. My father passed away. I gotta get back to the land before someone else takes it. I guess this is goodbye.
I told you I didn't need anybody.
Wilhelmina, what are you doing? It's time to go. You don't want me to go, do you? What am I supposed to do, Wilhelmina? I don't want her to go to New York. But I've been alone for a long time. I've never been scared of anything. But now I'm scared. What would I say to her? You want me to go back to the train station, don't you? Don't you? Okay. Let's go back and get her. Let's go back and get her. Come on, Willoughby.
Come on, let's go get her, Willoughby. Let's get her.
beautiful flowers for a beautiful lady. I started this journey alone, and I wanted to be alone with my war wounds. But God had other plans to keep me distracted. After all, it's not good for a man to be alone. Wilhelmina taught me that. Some goodbyes are happy. Some goodbyes are never given. And some goodbyes should have never happened at all.
What are you doing here? This is such a nice surprise.
Catherine's at home with child. We got married.
Wow, that's amazing.
We talked about it, and I thought it'd be best if Wilhelmina stayed here with you.
Really?
Yes.
Oh my goodness. Oh, baby. Oh my goodness, puppy. Oh my gosh, I love you. I missed you so much.
Tenting on the old campground. We're tenting tonight. We're tenting tonight. Tenting on the old campground. We've been tenting tonight on the old campground, thinking of days gone by. The loved ones at home gave us the hand and tear that said goodbye. And many are the hearts weary tonight, wishing for the war to cease. Many are the hearts looking for the right to see the dawn of peace. Thank you.
hear that musket roar? Can we ever end this war? And let the boys all go home so their mamas cry no more.